Hi students, here in this video we are going to discuss about the barometer, how it works and what is the equation through which we calculate the pressure. So barometer is a device. With the help of this device we can calculate the atmospheric pressure. This device is only used for calculating atmospheric pressure at a point. Okay, so how do we calculate it? So let's see. So what we do, we take a container filled with the fluid and we take a glass tube filled with the same fluid, and it is closed at the other end. Now it is kept like this position. Okay, so and the other end is closed and the liquid is filled in this tube like this. It is completely filled. Now what we do, we just reverse it and keep this tube in this fluid and open this front stopper. So when we open the stopper, so fluid will getting down. So but that will create the vacuum at the top of this fluid tube, and like this, but at some height this fluid will stop getting down. So let's say the reading in this barometer is H. So now we want to calculate the atmospheric pressure. So we are going to take a point over here. Let's say this is a point A, and we are going to take another point, that is point B. So now according to this pressure, the pressure at A and pressure at B will be equal. Pressure at A and pressure at B will be equal. Now pressure at A is the atmospheric pressure. So pressure at A is atmospheric pressure P naught, and pressure at B we can calculate with the help of this air column. So in this in the last classes we have already studied the variation of pressure with the depth. So here this pressure is zero. Now if we go down and calculate pressure at B with this column of fluid, so pressure at B will be rho of the fluid multiplied by G multiplied by reading H. Okay, so now pressure at A and pressure at B is equal. So that's why atmospheric pressure will be equals to rho into G into H. So this is a simple formula. With the help of this we can calculate the pressure, atmospheric pressure. Now see, over here if you use a different kind of fluid, the height of the column will be different. So now generally we prefer to use the mercury, because we know the density for the mercury is 13,600 kilogram per meter cube, right? So it is a high density, that's why this height of the air column will be low. Now if you calculate this atmospheric pressure at the sea level, it will be 1.01 into 10 to the power 5 pascals. It is also called as 1 atmospheric pressure. Now if you calculate height of the mercury column, so it will be P naught divided by rho G. That will be approximately coming out as 76 centimeter. So now sometime the 76 centimeter of Hg is also referred as the atmospheric pressure at the sea level. So now this is how we use the barometer. And now there is another instrument, manometer. Manometer is also used for the calculating the pressure of a fluid. We will discuss that in the next video. Let's end over here. Thank you.